CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So friends, let's join in Dhwani Shala class 4.
Hello children, how are you all? Hope you are doing great and you and your family are healthy and safe at home. Do you have your pencil and notebook with you? Good. You and I are going to read together about a little tree. Do you have your textbook with you? Open the Marigold Book 4, Unit 2, to the lesson The Little Fir Tree on page 24. But let me introduce myself. I am Madhura, your friend, and I'll be talking to you in English. English is a language like any other language. If you listen carefully, you can easily understand all that I say. Every summer, I used to spend a lot of time under a tree opposite our home. It was a neem tree, a very big one, full of leaves. My grandmother would often sit under it. She would say that the air under a neem tree is unpolluted. I would often sit with my back supported against the tree trunk. I loved everything about the tree. The new green budding leaves in the spring, the yellowing leaves soon to fall, the twigs that my father used to brush his teeth. I loved to gaze at the blue sky through the branches. I could see the nest that a sparrow had built with such care. A squirrel lived in a hole in the tree. A friendly little guy with bright eyes and a bushy tail. A family of crows would perch on the tree at sunset, cawing, caw, caw, continuously. On the soil, there would be beetles and worms could be seen coming out from the mud. Today, I saw a line of black ants going by. It reminded me of school. We walked to the morning assembly in a line. We walked to class in a line. We went to the library in a line. In the afternoons, it was generally quiet with only the rustling sound of the leaves as if the trees was telling a story. Today, we will read a story together. The Little Fir Tree. Long, long ago, a magician named Shetty was returning home. You know who a magician is, right? Yes, a magician is a person who can do magic tricks. These tricks are amazing and everyone begins to think, how did he do that trick? You know, like making a coin disappear or making a correct guess or pulling a rabbit out of the hat. Anyway, Shetty was walking home when all of a sudden it began to rain. It rained heavily. Shetty looked for shelter. He saw a fir tree and ran to it. Soon the rain stopped. Shetty thanked the tree for giving him shelter. He said to the tree, I can give you 4 wishes. Whatever you want, you can wish for it. Now, for some time, the fir tree had been feeling unhappy. It was unhappy because it had leaves like needles, thin, sharp, and long. No birds built nests on it. They built nests on other trees that had plenty of branches and lots of green leaves. So, the tree said, I wish I had green leaves. Next morning, the tree was surprised and happy because its wish had been granted. It was covered with fresh green leaves. the little fir tree smiled at the sun. But what was this? A goat came by and started to eat the leaves. The tree could do nothing to stop it. The goat ate all the fresh green leaves. So the tree wished for gold leaves. The goat cannot eat gold leaves. They are not food, thought the tree. Next morning, again, the little fir tree was surprised and happy because its wish had come true. But, oh no, a man came along and took away all the gold leaves. Now, the tree thought, neither gold nor green. Let me ask for glass leaves. The goat cannot eat them and no man will take them. So, the tree wished for glass leaves. Next morning, it was happy to see itself covered with glass leaves. The glass shone in the sunlight. The tree was very happy. But at night, a strong wind blew. Whoosh! The glass leaves fell and broke into little pieces. The tree realized that the needle-like leaves were the best. So, for the last wish, the tree asked for its needle leaves back. Next morning, it found that its wish had come true. The little fir tree was once again covered with needle-like leaves. Ah, said the fir tree, I will never make foolish wishes again. Now, children, let me tell you a magic trick. For this, you will need a freshly cut lemon, paper, and a cotton earbud or a paintbrush. Only three things. A cut lemon, paper, and a cotton earbud or a paintbrush. Let's begin. Squeeze the lemon to get 10 to 15 ml of juice into a cup. This is about 1 big teaspoon of juice. Next, take the cotton earbud or paintbrush and dip it into the lemon juice. Use this to write your message on the paper. Keep it short. Happy birthday, or I can do magic, or anything else you want. You will be able to see the message when it is wet. Let the lemon juice message dry completely. It becomes invisible. That is, no one can read the message. It looks like a blank piece of paper. Okay, now when you want to present your magic trick, say abracadabra. Cover the paper with a clean cloth and gently press a warm iron on it. Switch off the heat and present the paper to the audience. Ta-da! The letters appear in brown, as if by magic. So children, there are so many professions in the world. Not just doctors, teachers or pilots. In a hospital, for instance, there are doctors, yes, but also nurses, receptionists and people who run the hospital. They are important too. Similarly, if you study well, later you can do agricultural science and help farmers grow better crops and a variety of trees. There is also something called hydroponics. You can grow vegetables with only water. No land required at all. That is also magic. So many things in life are magical and wonderful. When the glass doors of the library building open on their own as I near the doors, isn't it magic? When you watch TV, do you realize that you are actually watching people hundreds and thousands of miles away? Isn't that magic? So children, you can be a magician or a musician or a guitarist or an artist. The whole world is your stage. But right now, let us draw something. Please take up your pencil. I want you to draw a banana leaf for me. Will you do that? Yes. Think of a banana leaf and draw it. Okay? Are you done? Good. Next, draw a lotus leaf. Have you seen a lotus leaf? If you have, think of one and draw it. Others can draw later. Fine. Now, think of a coconut tree. Think of its leaves. Now, draw one leaf. It's all lines, isn't it? Good. Draw a, neem leaf. Excellent. Next, draw any leaf from your garden or flower pot or leafy vegetables from the kitchen. Any leaf. Very good. Children, I want you to look carefully around the room or veranda, wherever you are sitting. Look at the curtain or carpet or bedsheet. You will see some plain, some checks, some with patterns. Is there any cloth in your home with a leaf pattern? A sari or a bedsheet or a shirt? Next time, do observe patterns on clothes. Let's learn about parts of a tree. The main part of a tree, the thick brown part, is called the trunk. It holds up all the branches and leaves. As the tree grows older, the trunk becomes thicker. When a tree is cut down, you can know the age of the tree by counting the rings in the trunk. Every year, a new ring is added to the trunk, and that is why the trunk becomes thicker. Don't worry if you didn't understand this. You can always ask your elders or your teacher. The word trunk has other meanings as well. I'm sure you know that the trunk is a kind of a large box in which we keep things. Another meaning of trunk is the long, very long nose of which animal? Can you tell me? Wonderful! You are right. It is the elephant's nose. The next word that we will talk about is bark. Which animal barks? Correct. Dogs. But the bark of a tree is something different. The part of the trunk that you can touch and feel, the rough brown outer covering, is called the bark of the tree. The branches grow out of the trunk and spread in all directions. They have smaller sticks growing out called twigs. Of course, fruits and flowers and leaves you already know. You also know about roots, the part of the tree that grows deep into the ground. Let's play a game. Remember in the story, what did the fir tree want? At first, it wanted green leaves. then gold leaves, and after that glass leaves. Did you notice all three begin with the letter G? Green, gold, and glass. Now, be ready. I want you to think of three fruits that begin with the letter P. P as in pink. Yes. Write down the names of three fruits that begin with P. Yes, children. I'm waiting. Oh, someone said papaya. Good. Pear. Excellent. Pomegranate. Oh, I feel like clapping. Learn the spelling of pomegranate, children. P-O-M-E-G-R-A-N-A-T-E. Pomegranate. Oh, did someone say plantain? Excellent. Next letter. Are you ready? Okay. Write down the names of three vegetables beginning with C. Try. Go on. I'm waiting. Yes. Carrot. Wow. Something green, round. Cabbage. You also have cauliflower. Did someone say capsicum? These look like big words, children, but you are not afraid of big words, are you? It will take you only a minute to learn them. If you just repeat them every day, you will easily learn them. Now, name three parts of a tree that begin with B. I said B as in baby. Yes, bark, the outer brown part of the tree that we just discussed. And branch, of course. One more, please, children. Think. Come on, think. What grows on a tree? Fruits? Flowers, yes. A bud. Bud grows into flowers. You can play this game with your friends and family later. You can choose different categories such as cities, colors, countries, animals, and so on. Shall we do another activity now? Write the word unhappy. The little fir tree was unhappy because it had needle-like leaves and no birds built nests in it. I'll say a few sentences. You have to write down the word beginning with UN that you will hear. Let's start. In these days, we have to be very careful. It is unsafe to go out without a mask. Did you get it? The word was unsafe. Say with me, UNSAFE, unsafe. Next, my father took out a bunch of keys, selected one, and unlocked the door. Okay? Yes? The word was unlocked. Spell it. UNLOCKED. Unlocked. The shoes were too tight, so the child untied the shoelaces. The word here is untied. Spell it with me. UNTIED. Untied. No one had cleared the dustbin on the street for 3 days. It looked very unclean. Here, the word is unclean. Spell it. U N C L E A N. Unclean. Good. Children, will you write down some more words, please? Unimportant. I will say it slowly again. Unimportant. Unimportant. Next word. Unlucky. I'll repeat. Unlucky. Last word. Unhealthy. Unhealthy. I want you to try and make sentences from these words. Okay, now that you have got it, we will do a similar activity using IM. I'll say a few sentences. You have to write down the word beginning with IM that you will hear. Let's start. When someone helps you or gives you something, you say, "Thank you." This is good manners. You also say, "Please," if you are making a request. If you do this, you are a polite person, not at all impolite. Yes, did you hear the last word? The word was impolite. Let's spell it out. I-M-P-O-L-I-T-E. Impolite. Do you remember a poem about a train that went up a hill? It said, "I think I can." The train was saying that it is possible for it to go up a hill. But when something can't be done, you say it is impossible. Yes. So did you hear the last word? The word was impossible. Let's spell it out. I M P O S S I B L E. Impossible. Okay. The next word. Pure water is colorless and transparent. Impure water has germs, mud particles, dust, etc. If you drink impure water, you may fall sick. I'm sure you got the word. I have said it twice. The word was impure. Let's spell it out. I M P U R E. Impure. You have been very patient, children, listening to all that I say. Really good and patient. Not at all impatient. That's the word. Impatient. Let's spell it out. I M P A T I E N T. Impatient. We have learnt some opposites today. Repeat after me. Safe. Unsafe. Repeat, please. Safe. Unsafe. Locked. Unlocked. Repeat, please. Locked. Unlocked. Very good. Tied. Untied. Say it again. Tied. Untied. Okay. Next. Clean. Unclean. Repeat, please. Clean. Unclean. Good. Lucky. Unlucky. Say it again. Lucky. Unlucky. हेल्दी, अनहेल्दी. रिपीट प्लीज. हेल्दी, अनहेल्दी. एक्सेलेंट. नाउ प्योर, इम्प्योर. रिपीट प्लीज. प्योर, इम्प्योर. पोलाइट, इम्पोलाइट. से इट अगेन. पोलाइट, इम्पोलाइट. पॉसिबल, इम्पॉसिबल. गुड. पॉसिबल, इम्पॉसिबल. पेशेंट, इम्पेशेंट. रिपीट प्लीज. पेशेंट, इम्पेशेंट. नाउ वी कम टू अ वर्ड दैट हैज बोथ यू एन एंड आई एम. इम्पॉर्टेंट, अनइम्पॉर्टेंट. से इट अगेन विथ मी. इम्पॉर्टेंट. द ऑपोजिट इज अनइम्पॉर्टेंट. डू यू रिमेंबर अ स्टोरी कॉल्ड आई वॉन्ट? इट वॉज इन योर मैरीगोल्ड बुक विच यू स्टडीड इन क्लास टू. इट वॉज अबाउट अ मंकी, यू रिकॉल, विच वॉज अनहैप्पी अबाउट इट सेल्फ. द मंकी वॉन्टेड अ लॉन्ग नेक लाइक द जिराफ्स नेक. अ काइंड फेरी ग्रांटेड हिज विश जस्ट एज शेट्टी granted the fir tree's wish. But then the monkey realized that a combination of different animals was horrible. He looked like a monster. The fir tree too realized that the green and gold and glass leaves led to trouble. So children, you should be happy the way you are. Children who have straight hair want curly hair. Those who have curly hair will try everything to get straight hair. It doesn't matter if your nose is big or small. It doesn't matter if your face is round or oval. It doesn't matter whether you are a short or a tall person. Each one of you is unique and special. We should study and be hopeful and eat and play well. We should not wish foolishly for things. Think about it, children. Bye for now till we meet again.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti and Jagbandhu Jana. This program was recorded by Bati Langlingdo and technically assisted by Soumya Malik. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.